Up until this point, we have been using this markfile1.md as a test dummy. But in the first part of this episode, I want to focus on doing a little refactor that will help us be really granular about what we're actually testing. Let's go back to my press file parser test. What I'm thinking is this. I want to be able to pass in more than just a file name into press file parser. So what I'm thinking is I want to do a quick check and see if what was passed into press file parser is a file that exists. If it is, then we're going to continue to do what we're doing right now, which is to simply get the contents of that file. But if it's not, I'm going to go ahead and try to actually parse what was passed in instead. So let's see what that would look like. Let's start a new test underneath this test here. And I'm going to call it a string can also be used instead. Let's see what we have here. I'm going to copy this test into this test and let's modify it. So instead of passing in a file name, what I want to do is pass in a string. Let's talk about what is the minimum amount of data that I have to pass in to make that regular expression work. And the regular expression I'm talking about is the one with the dashes. So we know that it's expecting three dashes followed by a new line and then some sort of field. Let's call it title and then my title. And then I know that it's expecting a new line followed by three more dashes and then another new line and then this right here. Let's paste that in. For this test, I'm actually going to get rid of description. So what I'm going to change here is in press file parser, it's going to attempt to find this file. If it doesn't exist, then it's going to take whatever we passed in and try to use that instead. Let's run this test and get to work. So obviously it's giving us a file does not exist because what we're actually passing in is a string. Let's fix that. Back in our press file parser, the method in question is this one here. We're blindly taking whatever is passed in and getting that content. We're not checking if the file exists. We're not checking anything. So let's do that now. Using the file facade, we can check if a file exists. And that's file, colon, colon, exists. And we can pass in this file name. I'm going to use the shorthand on this. So if the file exists, we are going to get the file. Otherwise, I'm simply going to use this file name. Does that make sense? This file name is passed to the constructor. And in our case here, there it is. This is what we're passing to the constructor. Then we jump to split file, at which point we're going to check, does this file exist? In this case, it's going to fail, so we're going to jump to the else part. But if the file exists, as in this case here, obviously we know this is a real file, then we're going to get the contents of that file and use that to do our preg match. Let's run our test one more time. And we're back to green. Let's run the full suite. And we're still at green. So with the small refactor, we can pass in a file or we can pass in a string and they both work the same. Now I want to talk about a new type of field and that is a date field. We're going under the assumption that this blog post will have a date as most blog posts will have. So our users will be able to pass in a published at date. So what I want to do is sort of do some wishful programming here for a second. And we're going to call this test a date field gets parsed. Now with most Laravel, you expect dates to be a carbon instance. And I'm sure you're familiar with carbon, so we're not going to go into much detail, but carbon is one of those PHP packages that we talked about at the beginning that will help us work with dates. So as part of this test, I want to test that we are actually getting back a carbon instance. So let's complete this test so we can get started. I'm going to copy this and this and let's modify it. So we know we're going to be passing in a date. And our date, I'm going to say May 14th, 1988. And we don't have to pass anything here, so I'm going to actually erase that. So once we get our data, what are we expecting here? Well, we can't do an assert contain. Instead, let's do two separate assertions. This assert instance of, and what are we asserting this is an instance of? A carbon class. Match to data, and the key is going to be date. Now carbon here is being imported at the top as carbon. Furthermore, we're going to want to make sure that the date got parsed properly, as we are passing in a string and expecting a proper carbon instance. This assert equals, and let's change the formatting. I think that will give us the confidence that we're looking for. 05-14-1988. So if we took data at date and called the format method on, now we know that at this point, date is a carbon instance, because if we got to this part of the test, then we are sure that data date is a carbon instance. So that means we can call format method on it. Now let's pass in a string for the format. M for month in two digits, D for days in two digits, and a capital Y for a four-digit year. Okay, that's all. Let's see what happens. Obviously, we are failing to assert that it is an instance of carbon. Let's get to work. In our press file parser, we need a new step here. This process fields. Add method, protect it. So for our first step here in process fields, what I want to do is iterate through this data and try to match the field name to some sort of logic. Now, this is a very naive implementation. Bear with me. In the next lesson, we're going to refactor this into a nice reusable code. For each, this data as, and what do we have here? At this point, we actually have a field and we have a value. At this point, let's write an if statement. If field. And what is the field that we're looking for? We're trying to manipulate the date field. So if the field triple equals to date, then let's go ahead and die and dump value. I just want us to see what we have there. And there we go. We have a string containing our date. So let's do our carbon conversion here. This data, and as the key, we're going to use field equal to carbon parse. And we're going to pass the value. Let's delete our die and dump and run the test. And just like that, we're at green. Now you may understand right away that this breaks down fairly easily. But just for clarification, we're going to do one more stab at these if statements. And what I want to handle is that body. Currently, our test for body is simply making sure that we are getting the literal markdown back. But we know that in reality, we need to be parsing the markdown. So I'm going to modify this test just slightly so that we get what we're actually expecting. So we know that a pound results in an H1 tag. So H1 and H1. And we know that a new line is not really a new line, but it's going to be a paragraph, so a P tag. So now this test will start to fail because we are not parsing. Let's see how we can fix that. Let's find the easiest way that we can make that test back to green. We're going to add an else if. So if field triple equals body, so then we know that at this stage, we're at the body, this data field equal to, and we know that we have our markdown parser. So all we have to do is just call the parse method on it. Okay, markdown parser, parse, pass through the value. Let's run the test one more time. And there we go, we're at green. Let's run the entire suite, we're still at green. In the next lesson, we're gonna use our tests to guide a very nice refactor out of this into a more object-oriented approach. Stay tuned.